With donations running low while they would usually be stocking up for hurricane season, the Cape Coral Caring Center had to look outside the box to raise money and then receive those donations.
NBC2's Derek Cobb went along for the ride along of the canals of Cape Coral for the first ever Call to Feed the Cape.
Honestly, where else would you rather be on a beautiful day like today than out on the water and on a boat? Well, the Women's Council of Realtors in Cape Coral decided to combine their love of music and their love of water in a very unique way to help raise money for families in need.
After a short ride across the Caloosahatchee River, the call to feed the Cape begins.
These are not normal times. Clearly, I don't have to tell you that. These are different times, and we have to kind of think outside the box.
For the Cape Coral Caring Center and Emergency Food Center, that unique idea was heading out on the water with a musician looking for donations.
A lot of tears have been shed by me and my staff, and things like this, these events have help dry our tears.
While their shelves may look full, this site usually supports 3 to 5 families a day, but is now up and over 1,000 people a week.
Normally, they're really full right now, but with everybody being out of work and children out of school, food comes in, it goes right out. So there's always a need.
So the donations started, not just by water, but also by land. An easy cause to get behind for those embedded in the community.
The more I give back, the more I get. It's just been a win-win situation.
We've been able to help so many people, and it's just, it makes everyone feel so good.
And this is not the last time you are going to hear the call to feed the Cape through the canals of Cape Coral.
I think it's a fabulous idea, and people clearly are enjoying it and liking it. And, you know, we have all these wonderful canals, and if we can use them to help people, what's better than that?
For more